The internet is full of bro science, fake knowledge, half information or propaganda. Your quest of reliable, authentic health information ends here. So subscribe this channel and hit the bell icon and you never have to go anywhere else ever again.
Hello everyone, how are you today? I am Dr. Paramjeet and you're watching Dr. Education. Welcome back to my channel. And today we will talk about cleansing your cologne in general, right? We will talk about, do we need to cleanse your cologne and how natural cologne cleanse are they needed? Do they work, right? There are many methods by which people will say you can cleanse your cologne, detoxify your whole digestive system. Some people say there is hydrotherapy, there is cologne irrigation, there is a salt water flush, there are so many other diets. Lemon diet, lemonade diet, herbal teas, herbal laxatives, enemas, there are some magnesium enzymes, etc., etc. Should you do that? Right? Do you need that? Right? What is the side effect? What is the benefit? Now, people say the benefits range from a simple feeling good, feeling lighter, losing weight, immunity gets better, you not get any infections, your sugars, diabetes will get controlled, blood pressures will get controlled, weight loss, increased immunity, a lot of benefit. But quite frankly, do these benefits actually happen? Is there any clinical evidence? No, there is no clinical evidence, there is no research proof, there is no documented evidence that these benefits do actually happen with any of these cologne cleanse technique. Do you know?
Tab aa jaate hain jab zarurat hoti tab nahi aate. Theek hai.
Alright, do you know that people used to actually insert long tubes inside your mouth and then insert liters of these kind of enemas, laxatives or fluid, salt water, etc., etc., in order to just flush or detox your cologne, which actually led to a lot of problem in the 2000, right, some years back, right? In these kind of times, they used to do enemas, and most of these enema preparations can lead to major symptom, major problems in like heart attacks, heart failures, electrolyte imbalance, which leads to heart attack, heart failure, increased potassium, increased sodium in your blood, right? These are very, very harmful things. Even so harmful that these equipments which were used actually could lead to infections, perforations of your intestines. That's why the FDA has started regulating these products, these equipments. That's why you don't see these equipments nowadays being used like this, right? But still, you know, people build up products which are said to be natural, but you can use them like this. So FDA cannot control the use of products, how they are used by yourself. So you have to use your mind, you have to use your brains, right? So remember, number one, all these kind of enemas, if you use them to actually flush your bowels, you might become dehydrated. Because you'll have watery stools. So loose motions will lead to dehydration. And second big problem, electrolyte imbalance. Third big problem, if you keep doing this regularly, you'll become dependent. You will not pass your stools without such kind of intervention. That's a big problem, right? Then these kind of things, sometimes some herbal teas, enzymes are used. These kind of things can actually interact with medicines which you're already taking. Your thyroid medication, your diabetes, your blood pressure, heart medications, they can interact with them. Sometimes decrease or increase their effects. Very wrong things can happen. Auto intoxication can happen, which we discussed in the salt water flush video, right? Some things inside the enema, some enzymes, some laxative herbal teas can lead to a lot of irritation in the bowel, distension of the bowel, fatigue, right? Headache, decrease appetite, irritability. A lot of things can happen here. That can go wrong, right? Your normal flora can get disrupted and that can lead to increased opportunistic infections, right? That's why they ask you to take probiotics after these kind of flushes or cleanses or detox things. So technically, these are not right. People even use something like coffee enema, which can lead to severe perforations in the rectum, right? Irritation, gastritis, so much distension of the abdomen. Oh my God, those are so harmful, right? Coffee enema, have you heard about it? It's actually there. And the benefits are so vague, unproven. There is no actual benefit more than placebo. People say, people will tell you, they will see blogs, you will see reviews, testimonials, I got benefit. Why? Because obviously if you'll say it, give something to somebody, okay, take this, this is good. So if you give that, they will use it thinking that they are doing something good to the body. And just by thinking, you'll see some benefits. This happens. Just like when you tell a person that, okay, masturbation is wrong, these people actually masturbate and feel bad and they become depressed and they feel, okay, I am weak. I'm feeling those illness just because of that placebo effect. You can feel better also, you can feel worse also. That's the power of placebo, of your mind. But frankly, there is no benefit of any colon cleanse. It's actually not needed. Why? Because number one, your normal flora, the nice good bacteria is living in the colon itself, actually are capable of detoxifying the food waste products which happen inside your body, which collect inside the body. Number two, your liver is very well capable of neutralizing all the toxins which you eat or which are produced by the degradation of your food products. Number three, your mucous membranes, mucosa inside the intestines actually is a thick multi-layered fluid like saliva. It's a mucus style thing and this stops bad bacteria, infections, bad toxins to enter inside your blood. And if you flush them out, you actually destroy this mucus lining. Right, you destroy the intestinal ciliary mucosa lining, and these kind of intestinal linings regenerates very fast. So even if you don't do any kind of flushes, these regenerate so fast that they won't allow any buildup of any harmful substance over them. They regenerate more faster than any tissue in your blood, in the body. Right? Remember, bowel movements are variable in every individual. Some people can go for passing your motions once a day, some twice, sometimes three times in a week. So it's normal. It's absolutely normal. And passing more stools in a day does not mean you're cleansing or you're losing weight or you're doing good to your body. Right? You rather will lose water. Right? Remember, body absorbs most of the nutrients from the food even before the food reaches the large intestine. So there is no cleanse, no safety in any cleanse diet. There is no safety in any natural cleanse diet, right? Something if it uses natural word, it does not mean safe. All right, please understand the concept. If you are still need any proof, you can go and research on any research websites like PubMed, ResearchGate, and see for yourself. There is no research proof. There is no logic here, right? Don't use such bullshit diets. Think about logical interventions, and weight loss is all about calorie deficits. A lot of videos are there on my channel. You can watch them and make sure to share this video. It's very important to, you know, cleanse people's mind of these bullshit concepts. So make sure to give me a like if you like the video. I'm Dr. Paramjeet. You're watching Dr. Education. Stay connected, guys, and stay healthy.